Hello and welcome everyone. So in the previous video we have seen about how to set up a Swagger module for the application, and what we needed is we needed a few packages, which is like Swagger UI Express is required, and we needed Nest.js Swagger. So these are the two modules which we needed, Nest.js Swagger and Swagger UI Express. And when we did npm run start, now we are able to see the Swagger spec. I mean, this is all the configuration which we put in the title, description and all. And right now we just have a dummy routes, right? User, forward slash, get, put, post. And we are able to see all these routes exposed. So once we do the cleanup, we will be able to see more. And for authorization, we have already provided that, okay, the token name will be access token. Once you provide the input that we have already defined in the Swagger module, if you just look at it, that access, the bearer token will be the access token. The title and description we are getting from this config interface. So you can change these titles and the tags. So now we are able to see the Swagger documentation for the Nest.js API. Now next thing where we are moving towards is, first of all, either we can create a config service. Okay, let's start with the MongoDB. Now we are able to create a controller and services and all these things. In the previous video we created a submodules, like, okay, we have a user. Okay, in the user controller we are getting the data from user service. Here we have a user service. In the user controller we were actually calling the user service and getting the data. But what if we have an integration with the, we wanted to integrate with the MongoDB module? For that we just need to import a particular module, which can be Nest.js Mongoose. So first we will do that. It's Nest.js and Mongoose. So before that, let me just push all this code. So this actually, this whole code is available in my repository. Five, and here we'll talk about Mongoose integration, you can see. Okay, now what we will do is, first we will do the installation. Npm install minus minus save Nest.js Mongoose. Okay, this module you need in your application, in your code. So we'll install Mongoose. Now how to just initialize this particular module, then you just go to your module.js. And we have to import it. Here I go. Okay, and I can just import the Mongoose module. So what we are going to import is from Nest.js, and here we will get Mongoose module. So we can just pass this Mongoose module in the imports declaration. So in the imports we have a user module. Before that, what we can do is dot, so here you can see these three, all these methods we will talk in the detail, for root, for feature asynchronous, for root async. Sometimes when we wanted to asynchronously load the dynamic modules, for those we will need these methods, for root async and for feature async. Here we are just have all the configuration, so we are going to use for root, and we'll be passing the Mongo URI, Mongo underscore URI, considering that we have Mongo URI here. So what we will do is we will have a dot env somewhere. In the dot env we will specify our Mongo URI. And we'll just define the value of it, okay, later. So this is how we just include the MongoDB module. Now what you will do, you can create your module, like we have a user module. So in the user module, what other thing you have to do to access these MongoDB models and all, in any particular module wherever you go, you have to initialize this MongoDB module for accessing that particular models. Okay, user will have a user routes, user controller, user services. So they will be dealing with the MongoDB user model, okay, user schema. So what we can do is, in the user model we have to import this Mongoose module again. Here we can import it quickly, and here we just need to define the schema. Okay, the name of the schema which I wanted to provide for this particular user model is this, and this can be user schema that you have to pass. I mean, we should already be having user schema created. Port user schema from, you can say we already have a models, maybe models some at the central place. All the models can be kept, and we have user.schema. Okay, so in the SRC we can have models and we can create a user schema, right? So these schemas can be defined, so we can create a different models like user. In this user schema, what all things we have? We have all the attributes which we wanted to access in the user model. So for now I'll just create a very basic one. Here I have a password. So we are just trying to create some kind of an e-commerce interface, but for now I want to keep it very simple. Single model, username, password and address. Okay, and I will be just exporting this particular model. So here this is the schema. We are exporting this schema here, and we are getting the user schema available here. Now this user model, user controller, we are already importing in the main module, this user module. We don't need this in dummy routes, we can create them. We can just have one controller user forward slash get. Okay, or we can say ping route, which will be nothing but it will be just saying hello world. Okay, we can just import this get. Yeah, so we have now user controller, and we already have created this some guards, interceptors. We don't need guard. We can still use exception filter and locking interceptor. Okay, we are injecting the user service, and now after including this, so in the user module we have explicitly said, okay, Mongoose module is going to use user schema for this particular module. So in user module we can access this particular user schema, and we can do user.find, find by id, find and update, find by id and remove. All these operations we should be able to do in our user module. Okay, so we can just talk about like auth controller, like just doing a sign in, sign up, like login, where you will be accessing these all these user operations, user.find, find by id and user.create using register and sign up. Okay, so what we can do is, in the user controller itself we can create a DTO. I think DTO is already there, so we don't need to create a separate folder for this. Okay, I can just create a user.dto.ts. Okay, in user DTO I will be defining what all type of input we are accepting in the controller. Okay, so controllers is like, consider a simple example. I'm going to use user login and user sign up, right? So that we will cover in the coming video, otherwise it will be lengthy. So we'll be just writing few routes like login, register, validate, forget password, reset password. All these routes we can add in the user, or we can just create another auth module itself, which will take care of the authentication, login, registration and all. And user module we can just use only to manage the profile information and all.